Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Anders Carp, Senior Vice President and Head of Business Area Surveillance. I would also like to extend my sincere thanks to our hosts for having us this week, and we really look forward to participate, as Johan said, not only with the Gripen but also with the GlobalEye. So first let me start a bit about Saab in Finland. We've been a proud partner to the Finnish Defence Forces since 1946 when our company in this country was established. We're roughly 120 employees in various cities. We're in two main companies, Saab Finland Oy as well as Combitech Oy. Combitech is also a special partner to the Finnish Defence Forces. Certain note. In 2017, we signed an agreement with Aalto University for research and studies to be made over a time period where we are investing 20 million euros in the areas of advanced electronics, microwave technology, RF technology, etc. This, together with the technology center that we formed in Tampere the year later, is part of Saab AB's global R&D organization, where we do everything from really early studies and research to actual development of our current products. We see this to be an area where we will grow quite fast in the coming years, given the extremely good standard of Finnish engineers. We're also during this year, due to the to the contract we signed last year for the Squadron 2020 for the Finnish Navy, we will build up 9LV, which is the name of the command and control system we use for maritime use or naval ships. We will build a command and control / 9LV system center in Tampere and the piece most likely in Turku as well during the year. I mentioned the Squadron 2020, which is one of the most prestigious contracts actually to be signed worldwide last couple of years, given its not only its size, but also in the way that the Finnish customer actually performed the competition. A very detailed and thorough competition where we are extremely proud of have won. We also won the previous or the predecessor, the Hamina class midlife upgrade 2 years ago, including new torpedoes and command and control, combat management system, and so on. And we also won advanced simulators, among other contracts, the last years in Finland. So all in all, we are a proud partner with a large installed product base within the Navy, Army, and the Finnish Air Force as well. Just to give some piece of or outline a bit where I come from, I'm heading the sensor and command and control business within Saab. In sensors, we're both in active sensors as well as passive sensors, and this picture really shows where we try where we actually knit together all domains and all capabilities from a sensor and command control point of view within Saab. So we have the air domain where we have sensors, both active and passive. We do command and control for aircraft as well, or for the air forces. We do the same for our naval customers, land customers, and also some in the security domain. This has led to that we have a unique position to actually tie together a lot of sensors into a command and control system, which actually can bring the best situational awareness or a situational awareness picture for the customer. And one of the most or the hardest ways to do that is in a flying command and control center, using all sorts of active and passive sensors on a platform integrating all of those surveillance data that you get into one situational awareness picture, which gives the Air Force or the operator, the defense operator, the best possible view on what to do next. We started this in late 80s, early 90s, with, of course, back then, with Swedish Air Force on the Saab 340 platform. Now we extended that to 7 more customers worldwide on 3 other platforms. The latest, of course, being the GlobalEye, based on the Global 6000 and / Global 6500 platform. We have the knowledge, we have built up the knowledge over these years for not only the sensors, but of course also the integration part, the knowledge we have from aircraft manufacturing and development and manufacturing over the years, the sensor technology as well as command and control, put that all together into a platform. We're very happy to be able to participate in this challenge with a true force multiplier, and I think and hope that the Finnish Air Force will appreciate this capability and multiplying effect. With that, thank you.